Dear students, now we determine the total potential due to a group of point charges. Suppose electric potential due to a Q1 charge, it should be 1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught Q1 upon R. Suppose this is Q1 charge and at R distance there is a point P, and due to Q2 charge, again distance is R. It should be V2 equal to 1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught Q2 upon R, and due to another charge Q3, again distance is R. It should be 1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught Q3 upon R, and total potential it should be V1 plus V2 plus V3 plus up to, if there is n charge particle, Vn, as electric potential is a scalar quantity. And we can say 1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught Q1 upon R plus Q2 upon R plus up to Qn upon R. And in general, we can write 1 upon V equal to 1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught Q1 upon R plus Q2 upon R. We can write sigma Qi upon R, where I is varied from 1 to n. This is total potential due to the group of charges. And if charges are distributed uniformly, then we can say that potential, it should be 1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught. Summation is converted into integration, and Qi is converted in dq upon r, if charge distribution is uniform. Suppose there is a case of uniform linear charge distribution. This is a linear uniform charge distribution, and we can take there is a dl length, and charge of dl length is dq. Now we know that linear charge density is dq upon dl, and dq is equal to lambda dl. Now this dq becomes V is equal to 1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught integration lambda dl upon r, in case of linear charge distribution, lambda upon 4 pi epsilon naught integration dl upon r. This is linear integration. And charge distribution is two dimensional, then total potential should be, this linear charge distribution is converted into surface charge distribution, 4 pi epsilon naught integration. This is small distance, now small surface area upon R, and it becomes surface integration. This is total potential due to a group of charge when charge is distributed two dimensionally. And in case of three dimensional, this surface charge density is converted into volume charge density upon 4 pi epsilon naught. This surface integration becomes volume integration, volume closed integration, and this small area is converted into small volume upon R. This is total potential due to group of charges when charge distributed three dimensionally. Suppose this is a charge and this is the area of electric fields, and we know that electric field is 1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught Q upon R square. As distance is increased, electric field is decreased. At that place and that place, suppose there is an even electric field, and this is there E2 electric field, there is E3 electric field, and E3 is less than E2, less than even. And similarly, we know that electric potential is 1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught Q upon R. Potential, electric potential is also decreased as the distance is increased. It means, suppose there is a distance dr, and here potential due to this charge Q is V, and here suppose there is potential V, and here V plus dV. When we move from point A to B, potential is decreased from V plus dV to V. potential gradient, suppose it is represented by potential gradient. Potential gradient is rate of change of potential with distance in electric field is known as potential gradient, dV upon dr. As distance is increased, potential is decreased inside the electric field. And unit of potential gradient is volt per meter. And we can also determine the dimensional formula of potential gradient. Volt, potential means W upon Q, and this is distance meter. W, dimensional formula of W one work done, ML2 T inverse 2, and Q AT, dimensional formula of charge AT, distance meter L, and it becomes M L square upon L, L T inverse 2 upon T, T inverse 3 upon A, A inverse 1. This is dimensional formula of potential gradient. Now we find the relation between electric field and electric potential. We know that suppose there is a charged particle Q, and at r distance there is a test charge particle Q naught, and if and there is a force between these two charged particles, both charges are positive, there should be a repulsive force F, and suppose there is a small displacement dr in this direction. Direction of force and displacement are opposite to each other. It means work done, it should be force into minus dr, as dr and force are opposite to each other. And we know that force is Q naught E, as there is an electric field. At that place, there is an electric field due to this charged particle. And we can write dW, F is Q naught E into minus dr. And dW upon Q naught becomes equal to E minus E dr. This is work done upon charge. dW upon Q naught should be dV, as we know that V equal to W upon Q naught. Here work done is small, now potential becomes also small, and we can replace it by dV. It becomes dV equal to minus E into dr, and E equal to minus dV upon dr. It means electric field is equal to negative gradient of electric potential. This is relation between electric field and electric potential.